Hey everyone! A couple weeks ago, someone left a comment on my Understanding SPI Protocol video. Please share a video to read firmware using SPI BIOS Flash non-dismantling test program clip. So I got one of those clips, and in this video, we'll use the clip to read the BIOS off of this motherboard, and in a future video, we'll use the clip to write to the BIOS. Let's get started! So this was a Dell computer that I had back in the day. Go ahead and turn it on. Okay, we'll go ahead and press F1. There you can see we're running A11 firmware. And I powered off the computer. And I'll go ahead and just unplug that. And what we're going to be looking at is this little chip right here. All right, so I've got the Winbond chip under the microscope. And here we can see Winbond. And I'll turn a little bit. Actually, we can just edit that with our photo editing. So 25Q16 CVSIG. So I pulled up the data sheet. We see the product number and we see the package type. This describes the part number in detail, and it supports 3.3 volts from our flipper zero. We see the size, VCC, ground, chip select, and there's a dot on pin 1. So next I'll go into SPI MEM Manager, and we'll go down to wiring. And you can see this wiring diagram, and I've basically hooked up all the wires the way the wiring diagram said to. For pins 1 through 8. And pin 1 is that red wire. And so on my clip, we're going to find that red wire. And that's going to go to the dot, which was pin 1 on our chip. Okay, so let me go ahead and hook that up. Okay, I've hooked that up. So now that clip is just sitting on the chip. And if all goes well, we can go back and then go to read. And it's saying choose the chip vendor, so that's a good sign. And it's detected the size of our chip, and we said it was a CVSIG, so CV. And then we'll go ahead and say read. We'll name it BIOS underscore A11. Go ahead and save. So it's reading that chip right now. And it's applying power to that chip. And we're lucky that that power is not getting drained by anything else on the motherboard. And we're also lucky that it supported 3.3 volts. And then it's doing a verify. And this verify is reading the chip again and comparing it with what is on the file on our SD card. So if anything had interfered with the read, hopefully it won't interfere the same way the second time. Success. We'll go ahead and open that. We'll do a compare. CV. So now it's doing another verify from our file, comparing it with what's on the chip. And again, this step is redundant. You don't need to do it. I'm just doing it in case there was some interference and try to eliminate the chances that we had a misread. Success. So with 2 successful reads, more than likely, we read the contents of the chip. And looking at info, we can see we have a 2 MB file.
Okay, next we'll plug our flipper back into our USB port. I don't have the clip connected or anything. And then we'll go to SD card, apps data, SPI mem manager. Go ahead and right click download, and we'll save the file here.
Next, I'll go ahead and open Git Bash. Git Bash should have been installed when you installed the Git tools. Next, I'll switch into the directory where we have our firmware, and you can see that BIOS underscore 11.bin. I'll run strings on that, and this is dumping all the Unicode strings that it can find. One of the interesting strings here near the bottom of the file is this Optiplex 990. That's the version of my Dell, so maybe that's displayed somewhere. Next, we'll run the strings command, but this time with the dash A for the ASCII strings. That dumped a lot of different text. Let's go ahead and do a dash N7 so that the text has to be at least 7 characters long. And here we can see the full paths to the PDB files were stored in that BIOS file. So if we're not able to successfully update that Optiplex text, maybe we can update the paths of one of these PDB files. Maybe that won't get caught as a little Easter egg. So as we're scrolling through here, here's some EFI APIs. We can see the ROM as well. And it looks like I don't really see much user visible information. So that's interesting. Anyway, I thought that was pretty exciting that the Flipper Zero was able to extract that data off the chip. Next, let's go on the Dell support site for the Optiplex 990. And under older versions, we'll go ahead and download that A11 firmware, which is the one we're running. It looks like there's the download button. Okay. And then we'll also download the A13 version, which we can use in a future video when we're trying to update the chip. If we're able to figure out how that A11 file is there, maybe we can use the A13 to update. All right, so next I'll do a directory ls, and we'll go into that BIOS utilities folder. And this has tools that can take those exes and extract out the bin files. So our next step, we'll run Python and we'll use the main.py, and then we'll point it at that 0990-A11. And that extracted the firmware. Let's change that to A13, and that extracted that firmware. I'll go ahead and do a git remote so you can see where I found that BIOS utilities GitHub. So next we'll start a graphical user interface. And then in the BIOS utilities folder, we'll go into our A11 extracted and we'll copy the system BIOS A11. And we'll paste that back into our main root directory. And then we'll grab the one from A13, system BIOS, and we'll paste that back. So now we have those two bin files. So next we'll do a directory. I'm up one level, so let's go dot dot, and then we can do a directory. And we notice that those bin files are 4 megabytes instead of the 2 megabytes that we did when we extracted the memory from the chip. So we'll go ahead and run the split command, and we'll ask for 2 megabyte files. And we'll go ahead and use the dash D and the dash A1 switches, and then we'll provide our bin, and we'll name this A11 underscore. So this is just saying we want to name it with digits. The dash D is digits, and the dash A1 is 1 digit. So we have A11 underscore 0 and A11 underscore 1 for the second half of the file. Next, we'll do the same thing with A13. So we'll have an A13.0 and an A13.1. So we have a bunch of files that are all the same size. So let's do an MD5 sum of each file so we can get a unique hash. So great news, the file that we dumped on the Flipper Zero and our A11 underscore 1 seem to be the same. So we'll go ahead and double check that they actually are the same using the diff-s, and the dash s will just print a message if they are the same. And we'll pass in the file that we dumped on the Flipper, the BIOS A11, and our A11 underscore 1, and they are identical. So at this point, we've successfully used that test clip and the Flipper Zero to dump the memory of the BIOS. Please like and subscribe. In a future video, we can try using the Flipper Zero to write to the chip and see what happens when we update that chip with different firmware.